This is the video part 2 based on congruency of triangles. In this video, we are going to focus on corresponding parts of two triangles and how to prove or how to solve the questions of congruency of triangles. In the given figure, ABCD is a parallelogram, E is the midpoint of BC, DE produced meets AB produced at L. Prove that AB is equals to BL and AL is twice the DC. Now to prove the sides equal or angles equal, we need to first prove two congruent triangles. We have here two triangles, triangle DCE and triangle LBE. Now we need to find out three things equal, either side or angle. And remember, all this required three things will be given in the question either directly or indirectly. Here it is given E is the midpoint of BC, that means CE and BE are equal. CE is equals to BE, it is given. Now what else is given? Nothing given directly. It is given ABCD is a parallelogram, and from that we need to find out the remaining equal things. If it is a parallelogram, opposite sides are going to be parallel. And if we have two parallel sides or two parallel lines intersected by a transversal, we have alternate angles which are equal. So angle 1 is equals to angle 2 as they are alternate angles. The third thing is angle 3 and angle 4 are vertically opposite angles, so they are equal. Angle 3 is equals to angle 4, vertically opposite angles. So we have found out three pairs of equal parts just by using the questions or some of us our previous knowledge. So that's it. We have side, one angle and another angle, and if we look in the figure, the side is in between the two angles. So we have ASA criteria for congruency. Now the important thing is writing the equation of congruency with the correct sequence of alphabets. We have angle 1 at point C and angle 2 at point B. So point C corresponds to point B in these two triangles. So if we write C over here, we have to write B at the first place. Now angle 3 and angle 4 are equal and both are lying at point E in the respective triangles. So we have point E in the first triangle corresponds to point E in the second triangle. And obviously the remaining points will lie corresponding to each other. That is point D corresponds to point L. Now if we write DCE as our first triangle, then it is congruent to LBE triangle. You can find out the difference and you can see that the sequence remains the same. So once we have two congruent triangles written with the correct sequence, we can find out all their corresponding parts, like side CE in the first triangle corresponds to side BE in the second triangle. Side ED in the first triangle corresponds to side EL in the second triangle. All we need to see is the sequence of letters that we have written in the equation of congruency. If we say angle D in the first triangle, it corresponds to angle L in the second triangle. Now what is asked in our question is AL is equals to BL. So here we have BL, so it corresponds to CD. And since they are corresponding parts, we say that they are equal by CPCTC. Corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. Now again go back to the parallelogram. We say that opposite sides of parallelogram are equal. So CD is equals to AB. So in these two equations, CD is equals to BL, CD is equals to AB, and our common sense says BL is equals to AB. That is, we have proved our first part. AB and BL are equal. We can say B is midpoint of AL. So in other words, we can say AB twice of AB is equals to AL. And we know that opposite sides of parallelogram are equal. So instead of AB, we can write CD. So twice of CD is equals to AL. And this is our second required result. And how to decide which two triangles to be taken for proving congruency, and how to identify the three equal pairs of sides or angles which are given there in the question. Here in the given figure, AY is perpendicular to ZY, BY is perpendicular to XY, such that AY is equals to ZY and BY is equals to XY. Prove that AB is equals to ZX. AB is this side and ZX is lying over here. So it is by default we have to take such triangles which will include AB in one of them and ZX on another. So we can clearly identify triangle ABY and triangle ZXY. Now we have to find out the three equal things. We can see in the question two things are given equal. AY is equals to ZY. So we will find out AY in the figure, which is equal to ZY. Second thing is given, BY is equals to XY. So BY over here is equals to XY. Now if we see in our triangles, AY is in first triangle, which is equal to ZY in the second triangle. Similarly, BY in the first triangle is equal to XY, which is in second triangle. So we got two things from the question directly. Now how to find the third thing? The third side, obviously we cannot take because we are required to prove they are equal. So we have to go for angles. Two 90 degree angles are given. But if we look in our triangle, we have taken ABY triangle. So we have this complete angle as the part of that triangle. And in triangle ZXY, we have this angle as a part of that triangle. Only 90 degree is not the part of any of our required triangle. So how to prove angles are equal? Suppose if we give the names to these angles as angle 1, which is 90 degree, angle 2, again 90 degree, and a small part of this as angle 3. So if we see the blue angle, it is made up of two parts, angle 1 plus angle 3, that is 90 degree plus angle 3. If we see the red part of that angle in second triangle, it is angle 2 plus angle 3, which is again 90 degree plus angle 3. So if we add same number to 90 degree, obviously we are going to get equal number. So from this we can say angle BYA is equal to angle ZYX. So we have found out our three required things.